The Huawei Mate 9. I've been durability testing phones for quite a long time now. Most phones survive my tests, but out of the 6 phones on my shelf of shame that didn't survive, Huawei owns 2 of those slots. I like it when phones survive, but Huawei's history makes me a little nervous for this Mate 9. Let's get started. The phone is a bit bigger than I thought it would be, slightly larger than my Galaxy S7 Edge. But one thing I do like seeing on this phone are the 2 screws at the bottom. Not only is this a bonus for repairability, but also for durability, since the screws are physically attaching that rear panel to the frame, making the phone more structurally secure. Huawei has included a built-in screen protector on this phone. Personally, I always have a screen protector on my daily device, so this is good news, and is a nice gesture. But it does make me wonder if this was included by Huawei to hide inferior glass. The only way to find out is the scratch test. My set of most picks are used to check mineral hardness. Normally, smartphone glass will scratch at a level 6, plastic screen scratch at level 3, and real sapphire scratches at an 8 or a 9. Keys and coins normally won't do damage to a level 6 screen, which is good news because this Mate 9 scratches at a level 6. These are the same picks that I used with the Honor 6X that scratched at level 4. And if you understood what all those numbers meant, you've been watching my channel for too long and you should probably go outside. The front camera is protected by the same screen glass, so no worries about that scratching. And the earpiece is made out of metal, with really small holes that will keep out dirt and rocks. So thumbs up for that. Now it's time to find out what material this phone is really made of. The blade of truth reveals the wonderful sound of metal on metal, which is one of the premium materials included in most flagships. One neat little life hack that most people don't know about is that you can turn any Android phone into an iPhone in just a few seconds. This might be a downgrade in some cases, but you really can't even tell a difference. If I move up to the dual camera lenses on this Mate 9, you can see they are covered by glass, and that glass is not scratched by my razor blade. This is good news. The laser focus is off to the right side of the camera, and this is covered by plastic. Plastic does scratch, but it is still slightly protected by that raised lip of the camera lenses, so I wouldn't worry about this too much. The flash on the left side is also plastic, but it's still protected by that same camera lip as well, and won't ever be rubbing directly on a desk or flat surface. The fingerprint scanner is pretty easy to scratch. It's not made of glass or ceramic, unfortunately. I've had multiple phones survive heavily scratched fingerprint scanners like this, but this Mate 9 is not one of them. This is still not something to stress about though, and it's not a deal breaker. The scanner itself is recessed into the phone so it won't be easily damaged. It's mostly just interesting to see which phones survive and which ones don't. The sides of the phone are made of metal. It's nice to see that we don't have any material switching going on. That cold premium metal feeling surrounds all sides of the phone, and even the buttons are made of metal. Solid choice. The only place that plastic appears is the top and bottom of that back panel. This is for the antennas of the phone. Plastic allows the signal through, where metal would not. You can see the color difference between the shiny silver metal panel and the gray plastic bar at the top. We'll see if that plastic affects the build quality in just a second. Even though the back of my Mate 9 might currently look like an Apple product, most people will realize that it's not actually an iPhone when they see that it has useful features, like the headphone jack or the IR blaster that turns your cell phone into a universal remote control. It's gotta be nice having a phone that actually does stuff. The Mate 9 does have a 1080p IPS display though, very similar to the real iPhone. And this display lasts 9 seconds under the intense heat from my lighter before dying. But after the heat is removed, the pixels will turn back on and function like normal. This is mostly just cool to watch. It's time we find out how solid the phone really is. Bentest checked the structural integrity and build quality of the device. Only 6 of the 50 phones that I've tested have catastrophically failed. The Mate 9 survives the first round of the bend test. You can see the front screen lift out of the rear panel a bit, but the whole phone is still intact. Those screws at the bottom are keeping the phone together, and the back panel is adding support to the frame. They're working as a team, unlike the Honor 6X. After my extreme abuse, there is some minor flex to the phone frame, but that can be corrected while the device is still surviving. So this phone passes the bend test. And overall, this device gets a thumbs up from me. It'll be fun to see what it looks like from the inside during my teardown video. What else would you like to see me do to these phones during my durability tests? Let me know in the comments. And hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. Turn on the notifications so you know whether your next phone is durable or not before you go out and buy it. And share this video with any Mate 9 owners to let them know they made a good phone buying decision. Thanks for watching. I'll see you around.